My name is Aaron Sumrall. I'm a county extension agent for Texas AgriLife Extension for the part of the A&M University system. Right now, currently in San Jacinto County, and I'm also a PhD candidate at Texas A&M University in College Station. All right, on the traps, whenever you start thinking about your traps, your corral traps is what we're going to be mainly visiting about today. Main thing you want to do, starting at the ground, is make sure that all of your panels are flush with the ground. You do not want any spacing below that bottom line of your panel. Anything that a pig can get their nose under, they will go under. So you want to make sure that you're flush with the ground in all parts of your trap. Livestock trails can present an issue where you have to avoid having an avenue for those hogs to get their nose under that. Also, like what we talked about with the cameras, post spacing. Always space your post no more than every 4 feet. 3 to 4 feet is optimal in your post spacing. Whenever you drive your post in, if you look at the spade of the post at the bottom, if you're going to be moving the traps periodically, make sure that you don't drive the post in the ground to the point where the tip of the spade is below the ground. Reason being is you're going to have a lot of grass roots that are going to grow over the tops of the blade of that spade, and it's going to be more difficult to pull out. So, and it doesn't need to be that deep in addition. So what you're going to want to do is make sure that this trap maintains its integrity, but it's not too rigid with the post driven too deep where an animal can use that rigidity of the trap to escape. So next thing you want to think of is the height of the trap. Make sure that the height of each trap is never below 5 foot. The 5 foot height is what you want to look at as a minimum with the 4 inch square spacings. These are what they term as a horse panel or a utility panel. They're 4 inch by 4 inch square spacings, 5 foot high. You can get them in a 16 foot length or a 20 foot length. The size of the trap is going to be dictated sometimes based on the camera. If you have smaller sounders and you know that you can get away with a smaller trap. Ideally, bigger is better. You want to make sure you can get the biggest trap out there that you can afford to put out. The traps that what we use is typically a 5 to 7 panel trap, and we shape those traps. Always, rule of thumb is never put any right angles in your traps. Everything needs to be a flowing curve or circular shape, never putting a right angle in there to allow those animals a place to piggyback and find a way to get out of there. Tying your gate, your post to your gates or to your line post. On your gates, you're going to want to make sure that you put extra reinforcements on areas where you may have a weakness that exists. And that's going to be at your seams and where they join the post. And what we use to tie affix these panels to the post and the gate with is just a number 9 baling wire. And what we do on the gates is we put at least 5 or 6 ties on each side of the gate. Where each of the line posts, we will put a minimum of 4 ties to each of the line posts, with the first one at the bottom of the trap, and it increments up the top with 4 or 5 in there. At the seams of the trap, what we have is we'll overlap the seams of each panel with 4 inch. We'll put one panel of overlap, one slot of overlap at each of the seams, and we'll put at least 6 or 7 of the ties at each of those seams. That way it allows for the give in those seams. But make sure that you overlap your seam. And as far as the remainder of the trap, just making sure the main benefit of the corral type traps is your non-target species and the ease of release of those animals. A 5 foot fence does not present any issue for a deer to be able to escape. Obviously the raccoons and the opossum and things like that can crawl back through the panel spacing. So making sure that basically the only thing that you're going to hold in that trap is going to be the target species with feral pigs. In the event that you do have a proper facility to market your animals to, one of the concerns that you're going to have to think about while you're building your trap is how are you going to get those hogs out of that trap. Many times you may only have 1 or 2 folks that are there at a trap to try to load hogs and to transport hogs. You need to think about the trap's dimensions and what you can do to make it easier on you. One of the first things that you need to do while you're building your trap is to put in what we can term as a false wall into your trap. What that false wall is just simply another panel, an additional panel that's affixed to the perimeter of the perimeter wall of your trap that will allow you to basically sweep that panel around and reduce the size of your trap. Now what we've done here is in another smaller type scale is to create that false wall, and you need to find out where it's going to terminate at, but you just The ends of this panel will be attached by rope or by some type of a pulley system, which is very, very simple to assemble. But you'll be on the outside of the trap with the ropes attached to this or something like that. And you'll pull this panel around all the while sweeping your hogs to the front of the trap. Whenever you get this sweeped all the way to the front of the trap, swept to the front of the trap, it's going to affix as close to the trigger as you can get it and reduce the size of your trap. So with the addition of one additional 20-foot panel, we've cut the size of a relatively large trap by 3/4 in size. So it makes it a lot more readily available to load hogs out of this type of a trap or this size of a trap. Another thing is going to be your trap dimensions. The trap that we're in right now is a teardrop trap where we have a confined neck, almost the shape of a loading chute that you would find with other livestock species. Whereas opposed to the other trap that we talked about earlier being the lobed type clover end, this trap being the teardrop trap is a lot more readily used while removing feral pigs because it's easy to back a trailer up to the gate and load them out. Whereas on the lobed end of the trap, it's difficult to get the trailer close enough to the trap gate to load those animals because of the lobing not allowing that trailer to get close. So whenever you're thinking about marketing animals, first of all, you need to make sure you're taking them to an approved facility. Second of all, you need to think about the trap design that what you're gonna have to use to be more efficient in your loading efforts. And then again too, maybe a false wall, maybe something that you can incorporate into your trap designs to make it a little easier on you. But think about the marketing before you get started. And one of the more profitable marketing areas for feral hogs is marketing to yourself.